went off and I was able to dream of the wicked. Over cussing magic, Rex Jiggles, that's what they call it. Excited. Instead, the dreams used to be forced out of the empty hole inside my bed. Force myself back into deprivation. And put some on screen, more of that same kind of transparent help those ideas come out in me like Kundalini tracks that I got from someone. Or something, I don't remember. Oh yeah, it was the textual verse. And then that's it, was my life for a while. Other people say the same shit, but I still don't know how to do it. I'm pretty sure I haven't seen half of the stuff I've ever through. I haven't read about it. I remember getting to Terrence McKenna, Lily for a while after. And when I smoked salvia, I went and actually went and devoured time out of the books. I skipped a couple of pages, skipped the script like a rewind. Little Wayne complained about. Came out the second time I tried it. Because I had no fucking effect over the second time in it. And I caught up with it. Some of my memories intact again. Here I am revisiting a memory that I had lived in vision and didn't really have any recorded in my fucking memory banks yet, because I hadn't experienced it personally yet. Living the town of linear fucking person on the physical realm of consciousness. And but anyway, I actually put myself in into it. I mean, I don't know if that would actually happen, but I remember the whole fucking trip in between them, skipping the pages, being yelled at. I was supposed to be there next. Oh, is that what I assumed was the Book of Life? That's what my own memory took it. And it was even halfway walking through. I knew it was on the wrong page, because every time I came right back to my bed, I took my ball and threw it, smashed it. Cracked. Critically. Even. I knew that was a possibility. That was a death of a strong, I couldn't fucking break a goddamn sandwich. Life is internalized. Of course, more than this was another suffering of trying to show this side. But anyway, my brother was sitting there waiting there for the next year of the little space. Every time I came back, but half the time I came back, I was still in bed. I couldn't even fucking realize what happened. What the fuck was happening? I was in the wrong room. Wrong. And everything just was going so wrong. I mean, one minute I knew I was staying in there, ready to go to the head, to break through. All stressed out, doing what one, and his stomach, I felt his stomach come up out. I hope I didn't set a little silent hope for something that comes back and don't open my bed up any more than I already have it. And this is the crack of psychedelics, is what I always wanted to try it, because I couldn't try it myself. It depends on some things either, but I guess more accepted, but it would probably be just a sort of fucking chattering. But this is a more natural plan, I guess, but it's, even though DMT is more natural, because it's more natural to not plants but animals instead, I guess. Anyway. I just pop in for a moment every time, because every time that I realize it's a little moment, they seem like I got a fucking book over them, a fucking ideas talk, and I woke up from bed and bed, my brother not even living there yet. A couple months later, I tried it again. He was there that time. I specifically asked for it. Remember, I'm not remembering any of that shit I just said. And then smoked it. Felt that same kind of feeling. I fought against it. As I put that memory and put it back into position, and fucking explained the whole fucking thing to him while I was looking at the fucking TV turned off. Turned into a piece of fucking piece of paper with the lines of reality ready to rip any second, but I didn't want to forget again. I only had like 5 minutes before the shit wheeled off, and if I was as interconnected to reality, see, it was constantly overlapping parentheses that I was constantly adding was another pothead, popped into my head was I thought of something that might fit in there. This enemy wasn't even trying to do it, especially not with rhymes, because now when I move in large it's a sign, oh, that I was abandoning my sanity. That's the thing my mind was for anyway. She's so bad at me, she knows it's in me. I haven't slept or I've done this or something. It must be in the room, but it must be something wrong with me too. As I said before, I've been consumed. I've only been caught psychotic once. Well, twice actually, but it was the same time. I mean, they released me when I thought I was already cured, but I was still going through it, just kind of on this Jesus says for something. And for something that, like, I went home and read what I wrote, and I realized how stupid I was. Immediately smoked some THC to catch what I was up there. Such a relaxing vacation, a mental board for going straight to a therapy session, and making a fool out of myself, trying to pick up a phone and acting all like a control the universe, apparently. Everyone looking at me like I'm all open, crazy, sitting up and amazing, waiting things that would seem through my eyes is obviously oblivious to that. Because I'm dreaming, you're all part of me. That's the whole point of it, isn't it? You're the medicine ball, friends. So hard we spit on it, and how much pressure we put on the rules, and how much rules we try to bend like a card and do it, and how many people actually fucking listen to it. That's how much fucking trouble you cause to the fucking system. That's a lot of people's asses around there, but you in time out when you haven't actually done anything wrong. But it's, if you know already, you can do this. And if I'm taking the medicine away, I mean, you're gonna be medicating you anyway. If any of you go sit down and just shut the fuck up, don't be trying to be stupid. Why the fuck not? I mean, you already knew a legal video, of course, to go around. And if you need to do anyway, you didn't need to go out and get caught. You got the prescription. You had to be bothered going out anyway, getting it. And then, of course, it became spice. That shit was legal, but nothing ruined my fucking life. I mean, thank God. If I thank God, I guess I'll thank God, even though I don't have a fucking gun. I'm not that believe, but dang it, I'm glad I'm being proud of that. I stand up and say proudly that I'm fucking clueless as anyone else is. I mean, clueless as everyone else pretend they are, it is. They want to say that they want to grab it up because of college degree or some shit because of very well sick in fucking class because of water that out of their asses. And, you know, go through this standardization of a nation. Oh, the hell? I can't go it off that little tiny thing, can I? They're eliminating the circle I have in this mission. I couldn't go into the camp last time. I don't even need to just go fort there. At least last time I was under this much pressure that I had a tent to hide under. It's not like I can block the archers. Alright, let's just kill him quick. But fuck all the extra points. I don't really need that anyway. But the mission is about to kill me. Anyway, I say this one also because I think it sounds pretty awesome. Just to show anyone who listens to that, I was that fucking crazy, or lack thereof. I walk that through the line because I try to do something different every second of my life. I gotta overlap it all the time, sure. Even if I build capitalization on it.